this way, so far out into the darkness? Why couldn't we have brought more light?
Hello everyone, my name is Captain Jack and welcome back to Space Engineers. Today we're checking out a fantastic mod for the game. Now as you guys know, I'm a massive fan of a TV show called The Expanse. We've done a few battles including these magnificent ships over here, but today we're going to be talking about one of my most favourite mods I've recently rediscovered on the workshop. Now a while ago someone created a functioning Epstein drive, which we have in front of us now. It fell apart and didn't work very well due to some mod changes and some game changes, but luckily someone's come along and actually redone the mod. The link to it and the credit will be down below in the description. Definitely go check it out if you want to play around with it. But today we actually have a functioning Epstein drive, or Epstein drive, however you want to pronounce it. Now I've already put it on the Rocinante there, and I put it on the Doniger as well, you can see with giant four engines. Unfortunately I didn't have a behemoth to hand to put it on there, because I know that one has like eight drives or something like that, but you know, we'll have to find that one another time. But in the meantime, I'm going to tell you a little bit about the Epstein drive, what it does, how this mod works, and we're going to jump straight into it. So this version provides 50.0 mn of thrust and requires both electricity and hydrogen. The upside of this is there's no custom components, instead you can build them with what you already have. That basically means in the game you don't require anything, you know, custom components to build this. It does take a lot to build it here. We've got the core here, will take you about 3,250 thruster components, then 225 superconductors. So not massive amounts, but it is quite costly, so you have to build this at the last minute. You've also got 25 superconductors in just the thruster cone here. Obviously, the more you have, the faster you can go, essentially. I have included a speed mod in the world, so we can test it on later to see how fast everything goes. Anyway, as I was saying, the thruster will burn hydrogen at 5,000 efficiency rating, while the core will use electricity. Fuel burn will require two large ship large reactors running at 56 power or 5,000 megawatts of power, while idle the core will use 200 megawatts of power, so turn it off when not moving. When you turn off the core, any attached thrusters will stop functioning as well. The core now holds a small amount of hydrogen in it, it just needs a hydrogen tank, not just a conveyor, which is fair enough, pretty cool. So we're going to be doing a bit of a test run over here in a memento. Actually, we'll do that now, see how it works, so I can show you guys how fast this goes. So let's jump in our model of Atashi quickly. Where's the door? It's in this side. And we'll see how fast the ship can get up to speed. The door is locked. I'm just going to break down the door so I can get in a minute. And we'll give a test drive this. I know when I was playing around with some Expanse battles, you guys said you'd love to see a functioning Epstein drive. Well, we have it today. Right, we are lined in position here. I'm rolling around the other way now. All right, so let's see. We're currently sat at 0.0 meters a second. Let's see how fast. In 3, 2, 1, engage. Look at that, we're about to pass by 100 already. There we go, fully passing by 100 now. Look how good this looks. So bright as well. But when it comes to a full stop, I'm going to have to do a flip and burn to slow down, because the ship doesn't have that very good stopping thrusters, so we could end up going on for days. There you go, it's flip and burner fully. Alright, so I'm just jetting back to the Doniger a minute. I'm going to just sit there and then I'll show you how the mod actually looks, especially with the heavy detail on the thruster itself. Now with this, it definitely teaches you how to handle the extra like thrust and stuff like that, because you kind of have to use the main drive to actually slow down. What I'm going to do now is I'm just going to disable the core a minute so I can actually, you know, come in a little bit better. Let's see how well it goes. Like, the ship's a lot slower now, as you can see, I've disabled it. But even the model itself, we're going to take a closer look into it a minute. The model itself fits on the ships really well, as you can see here. It's really cool. Anyway, I'm going to jump out a minute and just let the ship drift, as I'll be here for ages else. But let's take a look at it. So we've got two bits of information in this mod, or two places we can play with. We've got the Epstein core to my left, and then we've got the thruster cone to my right. Ignore the oxygen generator, that's just there for effects. Now, I believe they do have some custom sounds as well. So let's give it a shot a minute and see if we can hear anything. I'm going to fire the thruster. And we'll see how well it does. Let's see. We need a thruster cone 2. Let's go full firing. So there we go. It does have a custom sound effects. I think we just ran out of fuel straight away. Oh no, it is there. It's just a bit glitching out for a second. Okay, so it is kind of working. It's just glitching out, so you can only sort of see it. I think if we lower it down a minute, let's just give it a shot. Epsilon Drive Code 2. Lower it to half speed. It's because it's a station, it's slightly glitching out. But you get the idea there. The blue jet does look pretty cool and pretty nice. One of the best mods I've seen. It also has like a custom sound as well, which is nice to hear. You don't really get many Foster mods with custom sounds. Anyway, let's just... it will not shut down for some reason. There we go. Even has a custom sort of shutdown sound there. Interesting. Alright, so let's take a look at a closer detail of the mod itself. We'll start up a drive cone here. It looks really cool. And I love the way everything's attached like this properly. It definitely looks like it has just walked out of the Expanse TV show. And yeah, I love it. I mean, I thought I'd see something different in a mod, but this is really cool. And it's nice to know we're actually getting more Expanse things here in Space Engineers. It's something I've wanted for quite a while now. I know somebody was recommending me the PDCs and also the remote control torpedoes as well. So maybe we'll do a battle soon where we use a few of these Expanse themed mods and seeing if we create anything. If you guys would like to see another Expanse-themed battle, maybe with that Truman-class dreadnought, the UN ship that's on the workshop, I think we could definitely do something with that. Let us know down below in the comments and leave a like on the video, and of course, subscribe for more. But focusing on the details here, I can't go too much into the station here unless I use spectator mode quickly, but we can see how really detailed this mod is. I mean, just look around the drive here. It looks so cool. And I know when we're killing the hybrid in Season 2, there is a close-up shot of the Rocinante when it fires its main drive, and you do see everything burning up in it. It is really cool because you get to see the Epstein drive up front and close. It is so cool. I wish we could see more of the Rocinante when it comes to like that, but it's so cool. Now, we've also got these designs running around the edge here as well, which build up to the thruster profile are very nice, and even the fins on the side here as well. Those are pretty cool. Now, if we take a look at the main drive core over here, this is even better. We've got these sort of tanks leading in there. We've also got all the conveyor bits here. So Space Engineers themed and also Expanse themed as well. These are also pivoted down here at a bit of an angular route. And I love the way they're used. It really makes it look cool. Now, obviously, you latch the thruster onto this side here as well. The thruster clamps onto there. Bang. And it just looks like what I've set up here, which is pretty cool and straightforward. So it's very nice. So if we go around the side here again, some more details on top. Got a bit of scaffolding and sort of stuff there. You know, kind of a regular stuff you'd expect to see on this. But I know what you guys are asking for. You want to give us a test of a Doniger minute and see how well it performs. Obviously, we've got four drives over here. It does look a little bit out of place because of the size of them. It'd be nice if we could get different scaled Epstein drives, but I guess that could come sooner. So we'll basically now jump into the Doniger, give it a spin, and see how fast it goes. All right, I'm on board the Doniger now, so we're going to see how fast this ship actually goes. Now, this weighs like a ton, one hell of a lot more than the Rocinante. So let's see. We're starting off at 0 meters a second. In 3, 2, 1, go. Look at that, this ship is speeding away already. Quite faster than what it would under those hydrogen thrusters. Very nice. Look at those engines as well, it looks so cool. I'll let you guys appreciate this for a second. 130. And now if we come to slow down, I think slowing down the Doniger would be a lot harder. We're going to have to essentially rotate it now in order to slow down. But that's like the only difficult thing I could see. I guess the Expanse operates very differently when it comes to slowing down and stuff like that. Usually flip and burn the ship. I don't know how the Doniger would quite work in relation to that. Could you really flip and burn the Doniger? I don't know. It could be a bit more difficult, I guess. Then again, the Canterbury did that once. So, you know, that was kind of like quite a big ship as well. Who knows? So obviously now we're beginning our slowdown sequence. There we go. We should be fully slowed down now. There we go. Very nice. And the ship comes there. Very nice. So the mod all around is pretty cool. I don't think there's anything else I need to mention. There's a small fix for it. But basically, check it out in the workshop below. The Epstein Drive, a fantastic mod. I can't wait to play this more in some Expanse-themed battles. You just know it's going to be cool. But anyway, guys, I've been Cam Jack. Thank you for checking me out on this mod spotlight here. If you want to get it, the link is down below in the description. As always, if you'd like to see that Expanse-themed battle with a mod such as guided missiles, Epstein Drives, and PDCs, leave a like rating on this video and let me know down below in the comments. I've been Cam Jack. Thank you for watching, and I'll catch you next time. Goodbye.